Meteorologist Malachi Rogers in today with us, and much different weekend than we had last weekend.
Yeah, don't remind me of that, right? A lot of showers, a lot of storms, unfortunately, for folks with those outdoor activities. This weekend looks great, and it's starting out fantastic outside right now. Let's go to the coastline, Daytona Beach right now. 92 degrees, mostly sunny skies on our way to a fantastic afternoon. Highs climbing to the low 90s, right around 93 to 94 at Daytona. Inland temperatures are also warm. Live look at Universal's Islands of Adventure. We're at 90 degrees right now. Bright sunshine, as you see, and barely a cloud in the sky. Very similar weather pattern to what we saw yesterday. The difference between yesterday's weather and today's weather is that we're going to add about 3 to 5 degrees on those high temperatures. So it's going to be a warm one out there, and humidity levels are slowly starting to creep back up. But look at temperatures right now. 90-degree temperatures for Ocala and the Villages, 92 Daytona, as we just showed you, 88 in Sanford, 89 Orlando, 88 at Cocoa Beach, and 90 degrees in Melbourne. So if you're out this afternoon, remember the sunscreen, but plenty of sunshine and dry weather is in store. Winds are mainly out of the northwest right now, a little bit of a downsloping wind that has a tendency to be a little bit drier, a little more humid, and a little bit warmer, and that's going to be the case with those high temperatures today as well. Look at this. 94 is for Ocala and the Villages, 94 Mount Dora and Eustis, as well as Salt Springs. As we move along the I-4 corridor from Longwood to Orlando, 94s prevail. Same in Winter Park, Kissimmee, and Oviedo. And our last stop takes us along the shoreline with temperatures of 93 New Smyrna Beach, 91 Cocoa, and 91 at Palm Bay. Regardless of where you are across Central Florida over the next couple of days, expect plenty of sunshine and warm temperatures. In fact, we'll top out around 94 degrees this afternoon in Orlando, just in time for the evening commute. And we're still at 91 degrees by 7 p.m. So the sunshine, the heat, really not going anywhere over the next couple of days. Partly to mostly sunny skies and warm. As we take a look at your weekend forecast, high temperatures will remain in the mid and lower 90s. Our rain chances, though, will slowly start to increase, mainly for the second part of the weekend, and we're talking Sunday, with those higher rain chances holding off until next week. And of course, we're still watching the tropics. We have a couple of waves that we're watching, but there doesn't seem to be any potential out there right now. On our shoreline, plenty of sunshine, clear skies. Look at this. Not a cloud in the sky across Central Florida. And you can think a couple of things. There's an area of low pressure pulling up the eastern seaboard. That's dragging moisture away. And we also have an approaching cold front that this time of year is not going to make it all the way into Central Florida, but it gets close enough, it looks like, by Sunday that it could generate a few scattered showers in our northern counties. There it is right there, Sunday afternoon, Sunday evening, before it stalls out. We know this time of year, those fronts rarely come through, and we're not expecting this one to be anything any different. But as a result of that moisture getting a little bit closer, rain chances go up steadily, only about a 20% chance of rain on Saturday, 30% on Sunday, and then our seasonable 40% chances of rain for Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday of next week. Plenty of sunshine over the next couple of days. Hot temperatures, guys, as we see the rain hold off until next week.